Hello, you're watching Proactive London. I'm joined by Mo Khan, Chief Executive at hVIVO. Mo, good to see you again.
Good to see you too again. Thank you for having me on.
You're welcome. Mo, the hVIVO trading update was released this morning. Some major highlights in there, but to break it down, it'd be great if you could discuss the financial performance for 2023.
No, absolutely. And thank you for the opportunity. So it's been another wonderful year for hVIVO here across all the financial metrics. So if you look at our revenue, our EBITDA, our cash position, and our order book, they're all healthy, actually they're all record numbers compared to what we've seen historically within the company. So we recognized around £56 million in revenue in 2023. That's over a 15% year-on-year increase. So again, a strong performance built on with existing human challenge trial models we have, and also an expansion on the number of challenge trials we've conducted. We've also seen significant growth in our clinical consulting services that are conducted by our second subsidiary, Venn Life Sciences. So both of those subsidiaries have contributed very strongly to this good growth in our revenue. On the EBITDA side, we are at the moment going to about circa 22% EBITDA margins. But if you look at the absolute EBITDA for 23 compared to 24, sorry, 22, we're seeing overall an increase of greater than 30% year on year. So again, absolutely amazing numbers. As you would expect, as we continue to increase the occupancy rates of our beds in our quarantine units, we should be able to see an improvement in our EBITDA margin. So that's why you see a significant growth in the EBITDA margin as we continue to grow our revenue numbers. And both of these numbers, by the way, are offset somewhat by the client-funded new facility expansion, which I'll talk about in a little bit, and also the delays that were had an impact on us because of the MHRA issues, which affected all clinical trials starting up in the UK.
You mentioned the order book, which continues to grow. It's £80 million at year end. That's a weighted figure, right?
That's correct. And it's a good point. So for the last couple of years, you know, I've basically used a net or a weighted number only because we're not always 100% certain of how much of a contract we sign will be recognized into revenue. So what we do now is that when we sign a new contract, we sit with a team together and we put a percentage probability of how much of that contract will be recognized as revenue. And and to your point, that sits at £80 million, which is the highest it has been in the history of the company at the beginning of a year. And also it gives us kind of, I guess, more prudence in the fact that we are very comfortable that this number will be recognized as we continue to do on our work. And this £80 million order book is in spite of the fact that we have recognized, you know, £56 million worth of work last year. So this really goes into the fact that we've had a really successful sales numbers, which not only have basically funded the revenue we recognize, but also actually expanded the order book as we move forward in 2024. And again, as I say, you know, this is the most important forward-looking indicator for us as a company, and it's the highest in the history of the company. So it's giving us over 90% visibility for 2024. In fact, now we're seeing actually revenue that's already kind of booked for 2025, which is a great step forward for the company.
So a strong outlook for the year ahead then?
Oh, yeah, very strong. As I say, you know, 90% already booked up. We're guiding towards a £62 million in revenue for 2024. We've got some great steps going forward, especially this year, considering we're hoping to add three new challenge models to our portfolio of challenge agents. And on top of that, of course, we are looking to move to our new facility in Canary Wharf, which should happen towards the end of the first half of this year. And combining those two together, the kind of the additional diversity of our products or and our services we're offering to our clients. And on top of that, our capability now to actually expand and kind of increase the cap on our revenue potential. We are sitting in a very good position. I'm very bullish for 2024 and the company continues to grow from strength to strength.
Your strong cash balances are supporting the launch of an annual dividend. Can you tell us a little bit more about your dividend policy?
Yeah, so we gave a £3 million dividend in 2023. And you know, on top of that, we've been able to stockpile a cash of around £37 million at the end of last year. So we are in a very healthy position. So as a result of that, we will be giving out a dividend, an annual dividend starting this year. Of course, we're not going to close our accounts until April. So once we've got the full accounts published and we publish our annual report, we'll then give more color on our dividend policy. But I'm very pleased to announce at this stage that there will be an annual dividend this year, and that will become an annual thing for us as a company.
Mo, what's your short and midterm goals for the company?
Well, considering we've got this significant cash pile, we will be looking to conduct some M&A activity. This is not something we will rush into. We'll take our time. We'll find the right candidate. We don't want to really expand into completely new business areas, but we want to be able to use the business we currently have as a pivot and leverage that to recognize the additional revenues that we are currently not tapping into. So there's more to come on that in the coming months. And that's something we look to do maybe towards the end of this year and next year. On top of that, of course, we will have organic growth. So we are investing internally to expand the services we have. So our goal in 2028 really is to get to a target of £100 million in revenue. Majority of that will be contributed through doing more human challenge trials, maybe even bigger challenge trials, and also expanding on our Venn Life Sciences service portfolio in the early clinical development consulting services. But on top of that, the M&A activity should also help. So, I mean, considering you know where we come from and the strong growth we are seeing at the moment, we want to build on that and we want to continue that growth. So I think I'm very confident in the team that you know we've already laid a great foundation for 2024, considering our order book of over £80 million. That gives us comfort going forward the next 12, 18 months. But in addition to that, you know, the stockpile of cash you mentioned should hopefully fund additional M&A activity and get us to that £100 million target in 2028.
Well, I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress. Thank you very much for speaking with us today.
Thank you for having me on. Great talking to you. Thank you.
Mo Khan, Chief Executive at hVIVO.